all of this because of all of the deliverables of what is expected. You're going to have to keep and make 2D and make diagrams and drawings of every step along the way. That is the deliverable of this project. By making copies of each of them, you then have physical geometry from step to step to make drawings and diagrams of. And it's good practice. You can always go back a step rather than starting over or losing data. But when I copy, I'm a fan of moving diagonally. For example, if I were to copy it over here, then anytime I need to look at it from left or right view, that original copy is going to be in the way. If I move it straight up, anytime that I look at it from front or back view, that original copy is in the way. So I like to copy things diagonally so that any way that I look at, you know, this set of geometry, I can look at it in front view and see everything. I can look at it in side view and see it. Okay? You don't have to. It's my preference. It's good practice. It keeps you organized. All that kind of stuff. Okay. So the next step here. Again, this next step, you really have to understand the difference between rotate and rotate 3D, about which axes things get rotated for this to work well. But it says, using the X, Y, and Z axes, rotate in those three dimensions each set of the line plane pair no more than 15 degrees in each direction. Okay. So what that means is I'm going to take this line and plane and rotate it no more than 15 degrees in the X, no more than 15 degrees in the Y, no more than 15 degrees in the Z. And I'm going to do that three times. So it's going to be a total of 9 rotations. Okay? Whichever one I decide to start with, for example, say I start with this one here. My first rotation is not going to be about the x-axis because all it's going to do is make this thing spin in place. And for our purposes, that's not going to work. So if I choose the z line and plane, I'm not going to rotate about the z first, but I will eventually. The order doesn't matter as long as it is not itself first, okay? And the first rotation I do, I am going to enable copy so that I have a reference from where I started, but every rotation after that I'm not going to copy so that I don't have too much geometry floating around. I'll do the first one and show you what I mean by that. So, this first one here, the first rotation, let's say I rotate about the Z. Could do rotate 3D and define the z-axis, or I could just use the rotate command because it defaults to the z-axis. I want the center of the rotation to be here. I do want copy enabled. And this will add kind of another layer of complexity, but hopefully it will make sense. I'm going to define where the rotation is going to start. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to disable ortho, so that I can move less than 90 degrees. And as I move this, this number right here changes, right? I move this way, I move that way, and that number is telling me how far I'm rotating. For this step, we do not want to rotate more than 15 degrees in any direction, positive or negative, it doesn't matter. For geometry that will work moving forward, there are more correct answers within 15 degrees than there are outside of 15 degrees. It'll make sense when we get to part two. So in this case, if I could either click anywhere as long as this number were in bounds, or I could type in 13, 7 3/4, 1/2 degree. Doesn't matter, as long as it's I'm just going to click right here, some arbitrary input. But now what I have is a copy of that first rotation. Now the other two rotations, I'm not going to make the copies so that I don't have, so I don't lose track of what I've done in between. I only want where I started and where it's going to end. So again, I will rotate 3D. So I already rotated about the z-axis. Now I'm going to rotate about the y-axis. So I'll define that angle of rotation, which is that circle, right? I'm going to turn ortho on to make sure that I define 0, because I know in the about the y-axis it hasn't rotated yet, so I can reference the y-axis as, or sorry, the x-axis as the 0 for the y-axis. So if I click, right, and then disable ortho, then I can then move less than 90 degrees. And for this one, if I want to move up, I have a number that's, you know, greater than 15, but I could type in negative 3, right? Was not rotating about the z-axis.
I have a question for how you copied it. You copied the lines and the plane, right?
Yes.
And then you copied it from what point? Because if you copy it from the
oh, in terms of copying for another set?
You're rotating, yeah. Well, no.
When I did this, when I copied this over?
No. Just that arm, the one that's highlighted right now, it has the next question or the next.
Oh, we're not using specifically copy, we're using rotate copy.
Oh, rotate, okay. Gotcha.
What axis was that last?
That was about the X. So now I have my original line plane, which I should keep so I can continue referencing. And then I have my rotated line plane, which was less than 15 degrees in the X and the Y and the Z. And now we need to do that again for the Y line plane and the Z line plane. So do that right now.
So that one plane that you copied, you rotated it about three times. Okay, so we're taking that one, original one, and rotating that one less than 15 degrees going the X, Y, and Z axis, so it's rotated.
So yeah, for this step, a total of 9 rotations.
Okay.
I'm going to do 3 for the X, 3 for the Y, and 3 for the Z.
Okay.
The X is going to be XYZ, and the Y is going to be XYZ, and the Z is going to be XYZ.
Okay.
So I'll do this again here.
So reference point 1 is the center, right?
Rotate.
And then to get it angled
to
the center, not to the
first
plane, what was the second reference point?
Now, when I'm going to rotate this about the x-axis, I want to reference the original one and not the rotated one. If we reference the rotated one, it's not going to work moving forward. That's why I made a copy of the first rotation, so I could reference the original one, and just have an indication of where I rotated it to.
So I'm going to reference this original one.
And each, keep track of each rotation that you do, because if you accidentally rotate twice and those, the numbers of those rotations add up to more than 15, it's not going to work. And I will describe it on the next step. Well, sort of.
So our angles don't have to match yours, right?
No, they can be anything you want.
Just slightly different, right?
Yeah, you could do a half a degree, 1 degree. I have found that things less than 3 degrees are aggravating, and if you did every rotation exactly 15 degrees in every direction, it would work the best.
But we choose a measurement different than 15, do we have to stay consistent with our other rotation?
No.
Okay.
You can have 9 different angles. I don't recommend doing all 15. We want to see some variety.
So they should all be random, or maybe some or one set.
It's up to you. You can say all the x's are going to rotate 4 degrees, all the y's are going to rotate -9 degrees, and all the z's are going to rotate 15 degrees. You could have a rule. You could have no rule. It could be random. But when we get to the next step, we'll see what the difference in rotation does to the geometry we're going to create.
So, do you want a rotation around, but you also want us to tilt this?
The right way to think about it is that each of these line plane pairs, each one of them, we have 3 of them, each one of them will move or rotate around the x, the y, and the z.
Okay, so there's 3 rotations. Okay.
3 rotations for 3 sets of objects.
So
for example, the one that I highlighted, I already rotated it in the z. I already rotated it in the y, I think. Now I need to rotate it in the, I rotated it in the x. Now I need to rotate it in the y.
Okay.
Which is why you should keep track of what rotations you do per object.
So does the original count as one of the rotations?
No.
Okay.
But you do need to keep the original.
Okay, so there will be 4 working with that each axis.
No, just 2, because we don't need the intermediate. We just need where it started and where it ended. Do this one more for this one here. This one I don't want to start with rotate because it'll be about the z-axis. It is the z-axis. It's just going to spin. It's not going to work.
Okay, so that's why it didn't cost this. Okay.
started.
Depends on Chrome's like operating system, so I can't have a third party software. It's kind of useless.
Per line between group, there's three of them.
Yeah.
So we'll end up with six objects, the original and then the alternate. But we will have rotated them three times to get another line.
Yeah, I went,
Yeah.
That's.